And people mistakenly think that Please Come Home was a concept album, and it wasn't. It was just an album of themes. And the same can be said for The Big Dream. It's not a concept album as such. I think the main difference is the colour green, which sounds very strange. I wanted it to be a bit more sort of organic in terms of, I wanted the guitar sounds to be less processed. I'm a bit of a stickler. Being a child of the 80s, I kind of grew up and putting chorus on all the lead guitar, which makes it sound like Top Gun. So I kind of wanted a lot less Top Gun on this album. The other main difference is that in all the artwork, there's a lot more green. It's very kind of pastoral, and a lot of the photographs that we took were in the middle of a wood that I grew up playing in when I was a kid. And I just wanted the album to be, I kind of imagine, that's a strange thing to say, but I kind of see music in colours, and I wanted to see a lot more of the colour green. And I like that thing that comes across in a lot of the lyrical matter, as well as I say, just generally across the whole thing. In terms of production, I've approached it the same way with Craig. And the guitar playing, as I say, you know, I wanted a bit more of a 70s feel than an 80s feel. So, you know, there's little nods to a few, you know, sounds. There is some Mellotron on this album, which I can't believe I'm actually saying, but there is a smattering of Mellotron on The Big Dream. And yeah, I wanted more of a sort of a nod to Alan Parsons than maybe Top Gun on this one. I think as an album, I think it translates more as an entire piece from start to finish, which again is going to lend theory that it's a concept album when in actual fact it isn't. If ever I say something as a concept album, it's normally as a joke to upset somebody that doesn't like concept albums, but and send them around the twist trying to work out what the concept is. That musically speaking, The Big Dream, certainly I think when you play it as a whole and as an entirety, actually scans better as a from start to finish, or it has a through flow, you know, it makes sense in the order that it runs in. There's a long song on there called The Big Dream, which is an 8-minute instrumental piece, and I knew exactly where on the album that was going to go and the mood that it was going to capture. Because of course, when you put an album together, it undulates, you know, there is a theory that the first two songs have to be up tempo or loud and then we calm down. And that's, you know, that's a popular construct that we've been, you know, in the same vein that the Beatles said that pop songs had to be 3 minutes. The truth is, I just think it scans a lot better as an album from start to finish.